Welcome to my desktop. In this video, I'm going to show you how to edit photos in the Windows Photo Editor. I am in Windows 11. This also works for Windows 10. You'll see that I went down to my little Windows button and I am typing in the word photos to find my photo app. So I'm just going to click on that and it's going to take over my screen. I could make it smaller if I wanted to. And so here's the basic photos app. I have 100 billion photos on my computer from all kinds of places. But the place that I know where to how to find my photos is in my folders. So I go to my folders and it becomes much more reasonable. I can go to recent, I can go to pictures. I know where my things are in pictures. I actually have a folder set up that I've called sample. So those are sample photographs there. So I'm just gonna go there. So this is how you access the photographs in the Photos app. And there's an editor in here as well that can do the most basic, wonderful things. So it's got it lined up here by newest. I could also have it in here by oldest. So there's a couple of different options. Let's go to this wonderful photograph. So here's an image I have. And when I see the photo, I have different icons at the top. This icon right here is going to let me edit the image. This one here lets me rotate it. It doesn't need to be rotated, deleted, favorited, and more fun things. I can save it as, I can do all kinds of fun things. But we're just gonna stick with basic photo editing today. And so I just clicked on that. And the first thing that pops up is a cropping tool and a straightening tool. So I could, if my image wasn't straight, I could straighten it. It also, as you see when I played with it there, it showed me a little one-to-one. If I click on this down here, it gives me the aspect ratios. So I can be in a free frame where I can do all kinds of things to it. Or I could stick to the original aspect ratio, which happens to be 1:1. It's telling me that there. I could also go to different aspect ratios. These are all standard aspect ratios. For my students, I'm going to suggest that you try to stick to a standard aspect ratio, just because then if you want to trying to move this sideways. If you want to print it, it will make your life easier. You don't have to. I will say that if you're close to a 1:1, if you're like, this is almost a square, but not quite, just make it a square. So that's kind of just the basics of cropping. If I were going to actually do some cropping, and this is actually pretty well cropped, I would click on done here. It also will let me flip the image from side to side. That's interesting. Not a thing I want to do with a clock, or flip it upside down. So those are all the different things. Again, here I can rotate it one direction or the other. This is the place where I want my students to go, is adjustments. Here we have our most basic photo adjustments. If you are in Windows 10, you're going to see a light and a bar, but there's going to be a little arrow next to the word light. If you click on the arrow next to the word light in Windows 10, you will then get the sliders. This is what I want you to do, because this gives you the most control. So I'm just gonna explain these basic controls to you. And actually, maybe I should choose a different photo because this one looks really good, and it would be nice to show you something. See, I can say cancel. It'll tell me, you know, are you sure you don't want to save that? And I'm going to say yeah, because I'm not doing anything. So I can go back over here. Let's find something that hasn't been edited. I don't think this has been edited. There we go. And that's a pretty, this is what we would call a high key situation. So there's, I actually was, took a random shot in my light box in my studio. And here's the edit button, and it takes it a minute. So this is where I would go, okay, do I want to have all of this? Do I, how do I feel about this composition? If I stick with my original just to start with, you know, I can kind of come in a little bit. Do I like that? Do I want to, you know, delete all of that background stuff? Except I have this little shell over here that I really like. Now you get to see me think as we're going. Oh, that's kind of nice. I kind of like a little bit of open space here. Let's see. And I'm looking at my edges. Whenever I'm going to do cropping, I want to look really carefully at my edges. I like how this comes down into this corner. I kind of like, I've given myself some like framing with whiteness here. So let's go with that. We'll call this done. And then we'll go to the adjustment. And now here, brightness is exactly what it sounds like. It'll make everything brighter, wow, or everything darker. In this case, I think my brightness is pretty good because I'm looking at these things here. This was white glowing light. It's not gonna do particularly good if I try to make it gray. Exposure is sort of similar, but it is really only working or primarily working on highlights, a little bit different. So see, I can bring my exposure down and it doesn't gray everything out like my brightness did. So I can kind of give myself a little bit more, a little less exposure, excuse me, coming down. Contrast is taking all of these different tonal values and expanding or contracting them. So when I push my contrast, my brights will get a little bit brighter, my darks will get a little bit darker. Most of the time, pushing contrast is a good thing. A lot of people just don't generally give their photographs enough contrast to make it appealing. And my students should particularly pay attention to that. Highlights are just going to be these bright white things, the highlights, so I can make them, push them a little bit brighter if I wanted to. More often I'm going to kind of make sure that my highlights aren't too bright. Sometimes when I push contrast, everything looks good. My highlights need to be backed off. Sometimes the other thing that will happen is that my shadows might be a little too black. I can open them up is what we call it. Now you see I've pretty much taken my contrast away. Or I can also bring my shadows down a little bit without changing my highlights. So you can see I'll zero this out where you can kind of see how just the highlights or just the lowlights, the shadows are affected here. And then finally in this light section, I have a vignette. Sometimes just part of, like you can see this is a little bit bright here. I could actually use my vignette and kind of pull that down. You can see it's really subtle. If you're looking here, it's a very subtle little vignette. I can also do the reverse, which is really hard to see in this image because of the whiteness. But I can kind of pull a little bit of vignette. When I vignette and I make the outside edges a little bit darker, it helps bring my eye into the middle, which is a good thing most of the time. And then at the bottom here we have our color correction. So saturation is the intensity of the colors. I can push the saturation and you'll see all those colors get more intense, which depending on the scene could work or not. You have to kind of, it's better to not go too crazy. Of course, that's going to depend on what you're wanting to do. I'll just say for my class, for most of the time, you're going to want to be really careful about saturation. If you are doing an assignment that requires a black and white photograph, you will completely desaturate, and then I would encourage you to come up here and adjust your light and contrast. Usually what looks good in color needs a little bit more pop in black and white. And you can kind of see how we can kind of play with that and create a little bit more interesting image. I'm going to come back to the color aspect to show you these last two controls. When we talk about color, we have warmth and tint. So warmth is exactly what it sounds like. Warmer, adding more yellow. So this has to do with our color temperature. And I have the little blue spinny telling me it was trying to catch up. Or I can make it bluer. So depending on the light that you're shooting in, if you are using auto white balance on your camera, most of the time that's going to be pretty accurate. But sometimes it might need a little warming or cooling to make it accurate. Best to look at your whites and grays for that. And since I was on auto white balance, this really is a very accurate white and gray here. Tint is a little bit different, and tint is on the magenta green scale. So you can see as I push the tint, everything becomes more magenta. Magenta and green are opposite each other on our color light theory color wheel. A little bit different than pigment. So green, magenta, again, most of the time we're just gonna leave that as it is. One more thing, let's see if we can take away and see I can come back and let's just make this an image that has much less white on all of the edges just for fun. Okay, we're on original, done, and then I'm going to save it as a copy. So when I'm completely done with this, and honestly, it's sort of bugging me, the whole cropping situation here. I know it's just a demo and I should be able to just let it go. At any rate, I'm always, always, always going to tell my students, save a copy. Don't change your original file. So you could save here, but you'll see that the default is saving as a copy, and that's what I'm going to want you to do, because if you come back, and this is an interesting thing, pay attention to where it's saving to. This has a tendency to go the last place you saved a photo to, which may not be where you want to save a photo to this time. Your file name is, these are all just the dates because this is off of my iPhone. And I'm going to underscore and edit, adding that. So this is an edited version of this photo, and I will save it and it will put it into that place. And it takes a moment. And I think that's just about it. One more thing. I want to see if it will allow us to change the size And the answer is no. So there's some limitations to this photo editor, but it does a lot of things pretty simply and easily. And so when you're done, you just close it out and say bye. All right, that's it for today. I hope you found that helpful.